Today I wanted to quickly show how to create CentOS instance in AWS Cloud. As you might already know, most previous CentOS versions like version 7 or version 8 are already obsolete or will soon become end of life, so many people will want to move to CentOS 9, which is much newer and will be supported till around mid-2027, I think. But the installation process is exactly the same for CentOS 8 and CentOS 9, so that's why I mentioned them both in the title. So okay, let's create that CentOS server then. If you've never created any instances in AWS, I would suggest to watch one of the previous materials where it was described step by step. The link to that material should be displayed right now, and today I will only concentrate on how to choose correct operating system. So I kind of assume that you already know how to create the instance itself. So okay, we are in AWS Console, we go to EC2. As you can see, I don't have any instances running, so we can click on Launch Instance. And we can call it CentOS, maybe. We then scroll to the AMI portion, and this quick start selection is usually where you find something you are interested in, but not in this case. As you can see, there is no CentOS operating system. So what we have to do here is click that Browse More AMIs. If we click on that, it might take a while. Oh, as you can see now, it displayed 9,373 images, which is a lot, but I notice sometimes it takes a while until it's displayed. And as you can see, it says AWS and Trusted Third Parties AMIs. So you have to switch from Quick Start AMIs to that AWS Marketplace. It's a huge list of many different AMIs, but we are interested in CentOS, so we search for CentOS. And when I click Enter, my guess is similar to Amazon's, that you will be interested in one of the top ones. And I'm not gonna dwell into what is Stream exactly, but I guess that's probably what you want to install. What is very important though, it's CentOS Stream 9 from Amazon Web Services. Because as you can see, below you have CentOS Stream 9 as well, but it's from Hanway Software Technology. Or if you scroll even further, you've got with support by supported images. And the company is actually called supported images. So what's the difference then? The difference is very important. Once you are in Marketplace, you have to subscribe to those AMIs. So if I select CentOS Stream 9 from Amazon Web Services, if I click select, if you go to pricing, you have an overview here. It says typical total price 21 cents, but that includes price of the server itself, T3 small. So it's better shown in pricing. If you click that pricing tab, you see that the CentOS itself doesn't cost you anything. That 20 something cents come from T3 small server. But we already know we can use free tier. If we have free tier still valid, we can use a server that is within that free tier and we don't have to pay anything for that. So if I pick this CentOS operating system from AWS, and if I go for one of those micro instances that are included within free tier, then it will not cost me anything. But if we go back, if I cancel that, if we go back to any of the other ones, like this one, and then we go to pricing again, now you can see you not only have to pay for the instance, but you also pay for the operating system itself. So because you get a support from that supported images company, you have to pay for that support. So that's very important difference. And as you can see, I have to subscribe to that AMI. What that means is that I kind of agree to everything that is said here. So you have to read that, the product details, etc. And especially pricing, the most important information you are probably interested in. Because I, for example, want to use one that I don't have to pay anything for. And usually those from Amazon Web Services will be free, but you always have to read that pricing. And the last important bit is the architecture. So this is x86, which is like an Intel or AMD processor. Four Intel processors or AMD processors, I mean. And you have also, if you scroll down, or you can see here, CentOS Stream 8, but for ARM architecture. So this would be for like those Graviton instances from AWS. Okay, so let's go back to the very first one, CentOS 9 for x86 architecture. I select this. I get familiar with all this stuff that is here. Pricing is zero. That's the most important for me. So I can subscribe to that AMI now. So I click subscribe now. It should take me back. Oh, as you can see, it took me back to the previous page. And I can continue creating my server. So now I simply scroll further. I will pick the instance that is free tier eligible, because this is a new account, so I still have free tier. We created this account in one of the previous videos. That means the operating system is free and the T2 Micro is free for a year for me. 750 hours every month. Keeper login, I can pick the one we created, and everything else I can just leave as it is. And launch instance. But when you click the launch instance, let me click now, you might see you even, well, there isn't even information. Usually it takes 30 seconds, but it can take up to an hour. That's because of that subscription. You subscribed to that AMI, so kind of an agreement has to be created in the background, and the email will be sent to your email address, stating that you created a subscription to that AMI. And as you can see, well, okay, so this one was pretty quick, but as I said, sometimes it might take much longer, depends on which AMI you chose. It's usually when you choose third-party AMI, it takes much longer, because if you choose the one supported by Amazon, it's usually quick. Now we can click on our instance. We've got some details, it's still initializing. Let's give it a few seconds. So yes, that should be our CentOS 9 up and running. And if we pick that second image from the top, it would be CentOS 8 up and running. So as you can see, the procedure is exactly the same for both. I can just now click connect. And maybe not here, maybe we use SSH client. So I can just copy this, go to my terminal, just paste it. And it should take me, well, I have to confirm, yes, I know, this is my server, and I'm logged on to my server. And if I run cat, not car, let's see, OS release, I can see it's indeed CentOS Stream in version 9. And that's it, that's really all I wanted to show you today. Just do not forget to, once you are done, let's go back to instances, and just let's remove it, so it doesn't take our free tier hours unnecessarily. Okay, hope that makes sense.